The 3% has taken over the 97%. It's out of question. Now we know that. Now we see our freedom of speech being suppressed and brutally censored. We see our freedom of peaceful assembly taken away from us and patriots put in jail in Washington, D.C. There are political prisoners. We see our threats against the church, where they try to tell you how many people can come, how far away they have to sit from each other, when they can and cannot hold services, and your Second Amendment is next. Due process is gone. They'll put you into the tribunal, and they will get the result they want. They don't care about the rule of law, because once they achieve to get the person they want to run this country, we lost the rule of law, and I don't think they got away. I saw it come to us, a color revolution in the States and to other third world countries, and I saw it happen to America. Joe Biden did it. It was not about an election. It was his color revolution. Joe Biden, wherever he is, Joe down there. Because I don't like Joe's letter. I do not believe in my heart in the common sense that God blesses you with. In January 2017, Donald J. Trump gave his inaugural address. It seemed a little bit gloomy at the time when I listened to it. I would urge each and every one of you to go back, find it online if they haven't sent it to you yet. Watch it and listen to it again. Donald Trump knew then everything that we are learning about now. And when Donald Trump said too long, a handful of people have run this country, and now it's time to take it back and give it to the people. A member of every branch of the United States military came and stood behind it. The military of this country stands behind Donald Trump. He is still the president of the United States of America. Put it on tape. Send it to whoever's at the White House. Let them know we know the people. We know that he wanted it. He didn't just win it. It was a landslide of historic proportions. They cheated in South Carolina. They cheated in Georgia. They cheated in every state in this country. They didn't just cheat to get the top of the ballot. They cheated on the down ballots. I'd like to see some of the down ballot races to find out who really won and who really lost. These people cheated from the top to the bottom, and they cheated by using the computer voting systems. So we've got to have a forensic audit of every state, because we the people are not going to be denied our newly elected president, and we the people tell government who's going to serve. We don't have a cabal of people cheating in our elections and telling us who our leader is. This is America.
I do not believe Joe Biden is the president of the United States.